be driving or even cab riding, or maybe sauntering home from a bar. In all of this automotive surrounding, you don't know what hits you or how hard. Here's a story the papers have mentioned. Three men rode in a hearse yesterday. Then boom, an accident. All three were injured. The one in the coffin, of course, was okay. Then the send-off, the brass grated ears. And for the cantor, the notes were too high. The tears were phony, the words insincere. Only the man in the box didn't lie. His former boss, infamously dishonest, kissed him on the forehead, leading the pack. But the deceased man, ever so modest, he didn't once kiss anyone back. Guess what? With speeches, the rain don't bother. It started to shower. Nature's the boss. Everyone ran and quickly took cover. Only the dead man remained where he was. He could care less. That I truly admire. Now, the living aren't nearly as tough. Only the dead man, the man that expired. Oh, they're courageous. They are mad enough. People can beat you and treat you wrongly. They label you, put a stamp on your head. Truly, you're safe in one place only. Inside the coffin, presumably dead. You can have a single, or you can share. Living conditions here don't mean squat. The dead don't demand any special care. Jolly good fellas, I like them a lot.
Already dead.